mess drunk?
On this channel, I've covered plenty of Super Nintendo stuff, duh, but I also try and touch on everything from NES to Genesis to Game Boy Advance to more modern retro-inspired games. But one area I'd like to explore more in depth is arcade games, particularly games that haven't been commercially released on any home platform. I'm talking about stuff like the cliffhanger Edward Randy. No, not that cliffhanger. So here's an absolutely crazy action platformer game that never left Japan, and as you can see, it is balls-to-the-wall insanity. You play as the title character, and you whip the crap out of stuff Indiana Jones style. Yes, that's right, you whip helicopters right out of the sky. Sure, why not? You start out jumping from speedboat to speedboat, moving from left to right as jet skis try and cut you off and bad guys glide in from the sky and drop down on top of you. Then before you know it, the perspective switches and your boat is on rails headed straight toward your viewpoint. It is a really stunning visual. From there, you hop onto a gigantic train swinging from different platforms as an endless amount of enemies surround you. And this is just an appetizer for the second level, which is where the game really gets insane. You've switched to a car, ramping over canyons as enemies are dropped out of cargo planes, rocks fall on you, other cars try and cut you off, then a freaking tank shows up, blowing the bejesus out of the earth beneath you. Good God! And then before you know it, a giant friggin' bulldozer is trying to run you down. From there, you climb some really unstable construction platforms. I think there might be an OSHA violation here somewhere. All while these gigantic robotic hands try and grab you. That, of course, is the boss that you eventually have to defeat, and it looks like a cross between something you'd see in Wild Guns and Alien Soldier. What the hell is this thing? And after you beat him once, he comes back as some kind of hideous, rotting robot zombie thing. It's so freaking cool. The level after that somehow gets even more ridiculous as you find yourself not just standing on a biplane, but jumping between biplanes in midair and even using your whip to swing between them. This is seriously like something out of the most ridiculous Schwarzenegger or Stallone or Indiana Jones movie you could possibly conjure up. It is way over the top and I love it. But what makes it even better are the controls. They are extremely simple. One button jumps, another button attacks. You press down and jump to roll. And the only real issue here is when your whip latches onto a platform when you don't want it to. But just stick to attacking vertically when you can and try and stay on the highest platform, and it's really not a big deal. There's also no items here. You replenish health simply by killing enemies. And it's clear the dev team wanted the focus to be on the sheer spectacle of this game rather than complicate the gameplay with needless bells and whistles, and it was definitely the right call. Speaking of the dev team, this one was developed by Data East, and I want to take a second to talk about them a bit. Now, I see tons of comments praising 90s Capcom or 90s Konami and how great they were, but I rarely ever see anyone talk about Data East, so here goes. Data East deserves just as much praise as any developer in the 80s or 90s. They made some really polished arcade games that feature some of the craziest, most imaginative stuff you've ever seen, whether it's games like Nitro Ball, a game that somehow crosses a Smash TV-style shooter with the pinball, to Night Slashers, a truly gory, horror-based beat-em-up, to Boogie Wings, a shoot-em-up that lets you take control of all sorts of other vehicles, to Windjammers, a competitive frisbee game? Hey, it sounds lame, but it's pretty damn fun. That brings me back to the cliffhanger Edward Randy. No, there's not a lot of substance here, but there doesn't need to be. This game is just plain fun. Oh, and I didn't even mention that this game is two-player co-op. How can you beat that? My only other criticism here is that it's a really short playthrough, but really, if this game were any longer, I'd probably end up having a heart attack from how intense this game is. As of this video, the only way to play this one is with an emulator, so once again, this is a game you gotta play any way you can. Alright, I want to thank you for watching, and I hope you have a great rest of your day.